one isn't for posers. It's not for parking at nightclubs or taking weekend trips to Target. This is the 2010 Porsche 911 GT3, one of the most serious cars on the road. It demands devotion to the craft of driving. Being smooth demands genuine concentration. Fluid shifts are only achieved with deliberate shoves of the shifter matched to precise footwork with a monumentally heavy clutch. Steering loads are considerable. It's solid. It's loud. Most folks won't think the GT3 is worth the effort. But this isn't a car for most folks. If you're a skilled driver, and if your inputs with the controls are deliberate and decisive, then the GT3 will reward you with honest communication like no other car. But if you need numbers to prove the point, here they are. The 435 horsepower 3.8 liter flat six brings the rear drive GT3 to 60 miles per hour in 4 seconds flat, while the quarter mile arrives in 11.9 seconds at 119.4 miles per hour. From 60 miles per hour, the GT3 stops at 99 feet. No carbon ceramics either. The Porsche circles the skid pad at 0.98 G and runs through the slalom cones at 73.4 miles per hour. Had we had a more perfectly prepared testing surface, the results would have been even better. But perhaps the GT3's greatness can be summed up more simply.
Hi, I'm Chris Walton, Chief Road Test Editor with Inside Line. Today it's my privilege to be driving the Porsche 911 GT3 for video. And it's no secret around the office that this is my absolute favorite car in the whole world. Why? Because after you've driven this car, everything else feels soft and sloppy and slow. And just listen to this incredible flat six engine. Yeah.
So there you have it. The GT3 is a serious car for serious drivers, but it's also one of the best cars on the road. If you're not serious enough for it, buy a regular Porsche 911, or go to a driver's school. If you don't have the $112,000 for the GT3, win the lottery or rob a bank. It's just that good.